Hey PyTorch community, my name is Mike Ruberry, and I'm a software engineer working on PyTorch at Facebook. In this talk, recorded just after the PyTorch 1.10 release, I'm going to highlight the new scientific computing functionality added to PyTorch this past year. We've made a tremendous number of improvements, including three new modules and support for a new data type, and these updates should be of interest to many deep learning practitioners too. This talk will start by highlighting those three new modules, torch.fft for fast Fourier transforms, torch.linalg for linear algebra operations, and torch.special for special operations. Then we'll briefly discuss complex numbers and conclude by looking ahead to next year and thanking the PyTorch community members who helped develop this functionality. The torch.fft module, modeled after NumPy's FFT module, makes it easier than ever to work with hardware-accelerated fast Fourier transforms. These transforms are frequently used for signal processing and can also be used to implement a variety of neural network layers. Here's a list of operations in the torch.fft module. Community members familiar with NumPy will notice that this module is a superset of the functionality in NumPy's np.fft module. In addition to the operations from NumPy's FFT module, PyTorch also offers the short-time Fourier transform and its inverse. In fact, PyTorch's FFT module is a drop-in replacement for NumPy's FFT module, as this animation suggests. Here, a low-pass filter is converted to PyTorch just by replacing the NP namespace with the Torch namespace. The torch.fft module has been stable since PyTorch 1.8, and since then it's already seen use in multiple open source projects, including Torch Audio and Facebook Research's MMF and FastMRI projects. Now let's talk about the second scientific computing module added this past year, torch.linalg, a linear algebra module modeled after NumPy's linalg module. Torch.linalg has hardware-accelerated linear algebra operations to do everything from computing condition numbers to solving systems of equations. Just like the torch.fft module, torch.linalg implements a superset of NumPy's linear algebra functionality. These consistencies between PyTorch and NumPy should make the modules easy to use for community members who are already familiar with NumPy. You can pick them up quickly, and you can use them as a drop-in replacement in your existing programs. The torch.linalg module has been stable since PyTorch 1.9 and is already used in numerous open source projects, including Torch Vision, PyTorch Geometric, Bowtorch, which supports Bayesian optimization, and GPyTorch, which supports Gaussian processes. The last module I'll highlight is the new torch.special module. This module, modeled after SciPy's special module, has a variety of functions principally intended to facilitate work in statistical physics. Here's a list of the 30 operations that torch.special shipped with in PyTorch 1.10. It includes Bessel functions, error functions, gamma functions, and the Hurwitz zeta, in addition to other functions for statistical physics and working with distributions. Torch.special just went stable in the PyTorch 1.10 release, and we're excited to see what the community does with it. Now let's switch from talking about modules to talking about a new data type, complex numbers. Complex numbers are fundamental to fast Fourier transforms and many linear algebra operations, and PyTorch now supports them as a native data type, just like it supports Float32. Complex autograd, which allows for automatic differentiation and the optimization of complex neural networks, has been stable since PyTorch 1.9, and nearly every operation in the Torch, TorchFFT, and TorchLinalg modules supports complex tensor inputs and complex autograd. After that whirlwind of highlights over what we've done for the past year, let's conclude by looking ahead and thanking the PyTorch community members who helped make this possible. While PyTorch today supports numerous complex operations and complex autograd, full support for training complex neural networks lies ahead. This is an active research area, and you can already create modules with complex parameters in PyTorch if you're interested in exploring it. Going back to our modules, while torch.special has 30 operations as of this presentation, there are many more still requested by the community. For linear algebra, we're looking at adding solvers and making them easier to use. And finally, for the torch.fft module, we're looking at adding support for discrete cosine transforms. While we've added a tremendous amount of functionality over the past year, PyTorch is always growing. If you think we're missing something, or you'd like to get started developing PyTorch, then stop by our GitHub repository. And finally, a huge thank you to our PyTorch community members who helped implement these features, particularly the developers shown on this slide who made significant contributions to each of these projects.